Welcome to video on casting painting process control. Why painting is important process? As we are knowing, when customer receive the casting, he first look at the aesthetic part of it. Painting makes casting looks good aesthetically, so painting will impress customer, whereas bad painting will make customer feel unhappy about our quality at first sight. So painting plays an important role in improving customer satisfaction. Areas of painting process we are going to see: man, that is training and the qualification of operator; material, that is paint and thinner; machine, that is painting booth, painting gun, painting booth stand, etc.; method, that is the process of painting and tips for controlling it; measurement is the inspection of paint before painting and inspection of painted casting. First, we go to man or operator. As painting is a special process, painting operator must be trained and needs to be qualified for painting. His qualification is based on how he does the painting and how much skill he acquires for the painting process. He must know the SOP work instructions made for painting, and he should follow it irrespective of supervision. Material. Here, material is paint which we are using along with thinner. Basically, paint and thinner specifications are given by the customer, and foundry cannot do much about it. Machine, that is painting booth, must contain good light, suction points, water circulation system to make it user friendly. Painting booth, stand and spray gun must be cleaned before start of painting to avoid other paint get deposited on the casting. You can see here a picture of painting gun. Method. Methods here are basically the work instruction or SOPs made for painting process. There are three types of painting: spray painting, deep painting and brush painting. Spray painting. Spray painting is done with the gun. Spray gun must be cleaned with thinner before we start using it. Before you take paint, ensure you stir the paint well so that paint pigment and the liquid gets uniformly mixed up. Check before cup value, viscosity of the paint, and adjust it by adding paint or by adding thinner. You have to maintain before cup viscosity as per your requirement. Stir paint every half an hour to make the paint uniform and to get proper painting thickness on the casting. Every 1 hour, you need to check before cup value or viscosity and adjust it by adding either paint or thinner to maintain it. Spray dry air on casting to make it clean. Ensure clean and well shot blasted casting, rust-free casting taken for painting only. During the spray painting, key important parameter is your air pressure of spraying gun. It should be 3 to 4 bar required for spraying. Air which is used must be dry and free from moisture. Moisture in the air will make painted casting rusty after some time. Keep painted parts in a dry, clean area on either pallet or some sort of support. Do not keep painted casting directly on floor, as it will make well-painted casting dirty. Ensure enough light as operator can see the casting in all angles, and ensure that the paint is reached all over to cover total surface which needs to be painted. Deep painting. Here, casting is painted just by dipping it in the paint container instead of spraying. Here, the stirring plays an important role and needs to be stirred every half an hour. Also, removing excess paint from the casting is important. Brush painting. In brush painting, casting is painted just by applying paint using brush. Here, we are not talking on this topic, as this type of painting is very rarely used in casting painting. Paint drying. Paint needs to be dried up before it is handled by a person or dispatched to a customer. If it is touched by a person in wet condition, it will carry touch marks which are not accepted by customer most of the times. To avoid such incident, many times it is preferred to use QD, that is quick drying, or FD, that is fast drying paints, which dries faster than normal paint and the waiting time is reduced. Measurement. After painting, final inspection of painting is to be done by checking paint thickness. DFT meter is used and paint thickness is measured. If paint thickness is found okay with the given process, we can say the process is validated and the operator is qualified for the painting process. Safety and environment. It is important to have safety during the painting, as paint is hazardous material, and while spraying, it is getting sprinkled in air, it is important to wear goggle, mask, and rubber hand gloves for the safety of operator. Secondly, the sludge which is generated after paint is used, it is hazardous material and hence need to be disposed of as per government guidelines for environmental aspect. Thank you very much for patient hearing.